kind of looked good smoking. I was one of those.
Everybody looks cool, don't you think?
I started when I was 14. Used to go in the toilets at school.
You must look so cool.
Yeah, I bloody hate her. I really hate this class. I'm not going back to school. I'm going to leave when I'm 15. I really hate it. I gave up smoking because I live in California and there were no ashtrays in the state. And I would go for a meeting at CBS television or something and I'd take out a cigarette and they'd go, ah, an ashtray, well, I think we have one on the third floor, right, June? And then June, the secretary, would be sent off to find the ashtray and she'd come back and she'd go, it's not on the third floor. They go, well, we don't have one. So I gave up smoking in California. There was no point.
Oh, I live it.
They'll never stop smoking on some airlines, though. Like the... me and my husband, when we fly to Italy, the Alitalia pilots, I mean, it's like the no-smoking sign goes off on the runway, so they light up as they're taking off, you know? And all the smoke comes back out through the door, because they never shut the door, you know? And the stewardess, you know, there's like serving you your lunch, you know, prego, prego, andiamo. Allora, you know, they're never going to give up smoking.
I thought I could keep my shame a secret, but I've been a tobacco addict ever since Dorothy McDougal gave me a puff at a sixth-grade sleepover, and it's been a nicotine-stained road of degradation ever since. I've got a monkey on my back, and its name is Newport 100s, and it's getting worse. This is my second cigarette this semester. I need help.
I love Joel Carroll. He make me laugh when he play pool. I put picture of him in window. And every day at 3 o'clock when school let out, I have big line, yeah. I don't sell cigarette to minors. No, no, that would be wrong. I put nicotine in donut. Yeah.
What do you need, Kay?
Just two things, Darnetta. Could you countersign these loan applications and, could you tell me where I could score some pot?
Some what?
It's not for me. It's for Mother. She heard on the news that they've made it legal in California for medicinal purposes, but Dr. Lerner won't give her a prescription.
So you thought I could help?
Yes.
Why? 'Cause I'm black? You want me to get you some PCP and a crack pipe as well?
Oh, no offence intended, Darnetta. It's just that you were brought up in Jamaica, weren't you? And I hear ganja's compulsory there, isn't it?
Kay, I'm a single mother with two teenage sons.
Oh, so they might have some.
If they do, I'll kill them, and they both know that. So, you'll have to find your connection someplace else.
Oh, you didn't sign the...
More over here.
Do you think my car's gonna be all right parked out there? No. Excuse me. Do you know where I could find Mr. Carlos?
Carlos. Carlos who?
Oh, I don't know his second name. He did some work on my house. Hello.
We don't know Carlos here, lady.
For heaven's sake, I went through all this rigmarole before. I'm not with the INS, and he didn't get me pregnant.
Hey? Is that you?
Oh, what are you doing down there, you silly man?
You know, can't be too careful. Hey, how you doing?
Yes, good. Hello. Yes, it's him. This is my friend, Mr. Carlos.
Want a drink or something?
Yes, yes, yes. Lemonade would be nice. Yes. Oh, yeah. It wasn't
very helpful. Yeah, well, he's a human. Levántase, güey. I'll give her a lemonade and,
So, how's life treating you then?
Life is shit, Kay. I mean, the last job I had, I was a leaf blower in Encino. Before that, I sold oranges at some freeway off ramp, you know? And what kind of life is that for a man, huh? So I should have listened to my mother and never quit upholstery school.
Well, I might be able to put something your way. I need something on a fairly regular basis. And if you could provide it, there could be some sort of commission involved.
Yeah?
It's grass, you see.
I don't do yard work anymore. You know, my back is messed up.
No, it's weed. Pot. Hemp. Mary Jane.
Whoa, okay. Hey, you're not all that stuff, huh?
Oh, no. It's not for me, it's for Mother.
Oh, Mother. She's still alive?
Yeah, soldiering on.
Yeah, I remember when I met her, boy, that was scary. I thought I walked into one of the pod people.
Yes. Well, we've heard it's very therapeutic, you see, and we thought, you know, we could get some because... You know your way around the hood, or should I say, the barrier.
How much you need? Like a lid or whatever?
Oh, no. I'll buy the whole can.
No, I mean, a lid is like $75. Hawaiian, that's good stuff, isn't it? Really.
Yes, I can well imagine, yes. And how long would this lid last exactly?
Depends on the company you keep. Is it just for your mother? You got the Grateful Dead coming over. Hello.
It's a pungent smell, isn't it? Very earthy. Go well with a leg of lamb.
Oh, yeah, it goes well with a lot of things. You know, I had to pay extra for this stuff.
You're not stiffing me on the deal, are you, Mr. Carlos?
No way, Kay. This is some serious smoke here.
No,
because after all, nothing's too good for your mother, huh?
No, that's right. You know, maybe I should try it first, just to gauge the dosage, you know?
Yeah, that's a good idea. Maybe I should try some, too.
You know what?
Yes. Go for it.
Okay.
What's the matter?
Oh, I just had a terrible thought. That this might be the first step on a downward spiral of degradation. I could see myself in 6 months' time, sifting through dumpsters, wondering where my next fix is coming from, mugging old ladies.
Hey, beats yard work. Hey, come on. Go for it.
Right.
Here you go. Goes. Come on, you big girl. Ooh, yes.
I don't know what all the fuss is about, really.
Just roll another one. Big fat one this time.
We are all together. Carlos, I'm starving.
Oh, you got the munchies. I'm starving.
hungry and famished. I'm gonna go and defrost the turkey.
Oh, hey,
you roll mother another one,
you
right?
You got the munchies. Yes,
Then later we started singing Mellow Yellow, and I forgot that I'd left something in the oven. Well, the smoke alarm went off. Oh, terrifying noise, neighbours all over the place, and then the fire brigade, and then the fuzz, who found the dope, of course, because I hadn't had the presence of mind to stash it.
Oh, my God, did they charge you? Do you have a rap sheet now?
No, just a rap on the knuckles. It's Carlos I feel sorry for. You see, he doesn't have a green card. He tried to run away, but he lost the use of his legs.
Oh, don't you go beating up on yourself, Kay. We know why you did it. Thing is, do you think it helped your mother?
I'm not sure, Darnetta. But it did me the power of good.
Afternoon, ma'am.
Buenos dias.
You've been in Mexico long?
Just overnight, officer. My mother's an invalid, you see, and I was checking out the alternative health clinics in Tijuana. The sombreros for mother's wore, and I bought her some of those castanets. Mm. Not that she's going to be able to play them with her half-legged fingers. Because...
Just move it along, please, will you?
Yes, yes, of course.
Thank you
so much. Storm drain in the middle of the night.
Hey, you're a good woman, Kay. Have to do some odd jobs for you when we get back or something.
I'd like that, Mr. Carlos. I need a higher fence to hide the pot I'm growing in the garden.
Say what?
Yes. It's doing very well between the lima beans and the delphiniums. Yes, it's gonna be real primo shit.
Hi, I'm Linda. You know, I've been in the program for a number of years now, but this is a new meeting for me. I've been trying to figure out the precise moment that triggered the abuse, the dysfunction, and the disorder that had plagued my adult years. I was 15, I guess. It was my first week at Sammy Davis Junior Senior High.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Davinsky.
Good morning.
The new fish.
I'm Linda. Linda Wartkowski.
Well, I'm gonna call you Wart. You got any money?
Only my lunch money.
Cough it up, Wart.
Hey.
You wanna get cut?
Hey, knock it off, Angie.
This ain't your business, Jono.
Well, forget about it. I'm making it my business. Why don't you take your little toy, carve your initials in the crap? Big as all. I'm Jono.
Oh, everybody knows that. I mean, you're like a wheel or something. I'm Linda. Well, never mind who I am.
What? You mean you're nobody?
No, I don't mean that. Well, maybe I am. But I'm gonna be somebody someday. Like a singer or a movie star. Maybe it's just a stupid dream, but. We all have to have dreams, don't we, Jono?
Dreams? I don't even sleep. You want to smoke?
I don't. I mean, I've never.
Oh. It's always the first time.
Sorry.
First time for a lot of things.
That first puff, it seemed so harmless.
It was never going to be a problem for me, not for Linda Wharton.
I wanted too many things, too bad. I had neon in my eyes and a one-way ticket to the Big Apple.
Pretty good. Pretty good. Take a break, girls. Move your chairs to the second position for me, please. And make sure that Helen has your home phone number. You.
Me?
Yeah, you. What's your name?
Linda. Linda Wainscott.
What's your last show, Linda?
Oh, it wasn't exactly Broadway, Mr. Rossi. It was the Wrigley's commercial, the one without the twin.
Could you get your hat, please? You almost had it there at the end. Okay, stand here. Work with me a little bit.
Great.
Okay, sling down in this hip. Yeah, that's good. There. Relax, Linda.
Okay.
Relax. All right. There you go. So, you're going to move your hips.
Yes.
And your hips.
Yes.
Okay? Brand, yes. You ready? One, two, ready, and...
live in this really small town. My foster parents' only ambition was to get a home that didn't have wheels. Oh, but I always had this dream. My name was in lights. Linda, I haven't decided on my name yet, but the sound of applause is ringing in my ears.
You want one of these?
What are they?
It'll bring you down from all the cocaine we did. You want me to call you a cab?
Oh, you don't want me to stay the night?
Look, kid, my wife's curtain comes down at 10:30. It might be better if she doesn't find you here. Can you reach my socks?
Sure.
Thanks.
And maybe I will have a couple of those pills.
I didn't even make the cut for the chorus. I found out later, Bob pulled that same stunt on every extraordinarily talented dewy-eyed hoover who hit the Great White Way. But you know something? It just made me want to try harder. Gave me more to prove. It was Hollywood or bust, and Linda Westlake wanted both. And if she needed a little help along the way. I had a pill for getting up, a pill to go to bed. I even had a pill for picking up the dry cleaning. But booze, pills, and poppers were a dangerous combination, even though they were recommended by my dentist. One night, up at Hef's place, I actually passed out. Happily, my face landed in the lap of an ABC executive. 2 months later, I had my own series. And I finally settled on a name, Linda Granger, after Granger Delisle, my hairdresser, personal confidant, and coke dealer. I was a star, Vicky star of VIP Lounge. I always thought fame would quench the hunger inside me, but it only fueled it. Especially for Lady Snow. And you know where I found myself at 4 a.m. one morning? Freebasing in the valley.
We ain't had quite like this a long time. Wait a minute.
What have I done? Please forgive me.
Girl, what?
Police, the cops.
We gotta split this. They'll put you out.
That poor old drink on my ass is gonna blow me the fuck up.
That was when I hit my own personal bottom. Then God in his infinite goodness gave me cancer, and I was able to claw my way back to sanity and sobriety. And I realized that it all started with that first cigarette that Jono gave me. He's in prison for life, by the way, although the name Gotti still commands a lot of respect in New York. What I'm trying to tell you is that addiction can begin with that first fatal puff. So I beg you, please, give it up. Come on. Put them out on the count of three. We can do it together. One.
Hey, leave me something, Linda, huh?
I mean, this is all I got.
I kick junk, I kick crack, I kick booze. I cut out smoking. I want to feel like Debbie Boone.
Yeah, what do you... Screw you.
Oh, but I think about it, haven't I? Oh, I've got to stop doing these things. The secondhand smoke is killing me. Movie star.
How you like those lacerations, dearie?
Very good.
Yeah, they're just like the real thing. And I should know, because I got to the scene of the accident when Jane Mansfield's head was still rolling along the side of that highway. Sad thing was, I'd done her roots only 3 days prior. Can you believe her luck?
Would you mind not smoking? It affects my voice.
What? Was on the call sheet that's your corpse number two. So I don't think you're going to be straining your voice much, Jerry.
I'm singing in a showcase of Rent tonight.
Okay. Jeez Louise. You know, husky ain't bad, honey. Lauren Bacall made it because of a damaged larynx. I'll see you on the ice. Oh, don't touch your face. Don't touch him. Jesus Christ, what a pain in the ass. Okay, fellas.
Hey, Rube.
Sure, here's the rent. Damn, no talents.
There's no smoking on the set.
What?
There's no smoking on the set.
Oh, all right, mister. My father got me this job. Oh. Thank you.
Coffee.
Can't believe this. Feel like I'm 7 years old again.
I smell something.
Sure you do, honey. It's a bathroom. There's somebody in here. Occupado.
Is somebody smoking in there?
I had a little something off the mesquite grill at lunch. Maybe that's it. Jesus, Mary and Joseph.
There's no smoking in here.
Well, honey, what are you doing? I need some privacy here. I'm on the camp. What is this, the army?
I'm going to have to ask you to evacuate.
That is what I'm trying to do. Jeez. Oh! My oasis. Oh, jeez, Louise. I am going to finish this cigarette if it kills me. You know, they'll be telling us that this is no good for us next. Huh? Cheers. Oh. This country was built on the rights of the individual. Washington smoked. FDR smoked. Hell. Ugh. I powder Reagan's nose for those Chesterfield ads. Yeah. It's pleasurable. Soothes the nerves. Oh. Relaxes you.
One night.
and driving past Planet Hollywood, and there's Arnold Schwarzenegger and Bruce Willis, and their limousine's got a flat. And these women, they're tearing their clothes off. So they leap into my cab and they say, get us out of here. Take us somewhere decent to eat. So while I'm driving them to my cousin Momo's falafel hut, they light up two fucking great big Cuban cigars. I stop the cab. I tell them to get out. They go crazy. They say, do you know who we are? I say, I don't give a fuck. Nobody's smoking my cab. You smoke in my cab. Next person who get in, it smells like a moose took a shit, eh? I threw Halle Berry's ass out of the Brooklyn Bridge when lighting up a low-tar lock. I make no exceptions, my friend, eh?
Baby, there's no need for living in the past. Now I've found good love and gonna make it last. I tell the others don't bother me, cause when they look at you, they don't see what I see. No, I don't listen to their wasted lines. Have my eyes wide open and I see the signs, cause they don't know about us. They've never heard of love.
Good night, Trace.
Good night, Trace.
Good night, Trace.
Go home. Go home.
Go home.